Now starting with the next topic, that is number 4 is formation of gastrula. Now what is gastrula? It is the formation of 3 germ layers. It is actually formation of 3 germ layers. What are the 3 germ layers? Ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. So let us see how these 3 germ layers are going to form. Now the embryonal knob, which is present here, is going to arrange and become in a single layer. It's going to form a disc-like structure. So what is the first thing that we will see? This is the first layer. That is, it's going to arrange in a disc-like layer. The embryonal knob or the inner cell mass is going to arrange in a disc-like layer. And here we have the usual, the trophoblast layer. Just let me draw. These are the flat cells. Now from the trophoblast there are the finger-like projections which is already there and forming the placenta. So first, what is this? Formation of disc-like layer, okay, of the embryonal layer. Now this undergoes one division. So it's going to undergo one division to form long columnar cells and one layer of small cells. One layer of column-like cells and small cells. Column-like cells and small cells. The function of the small cells is not so important. We are concerned with the entire embryo is going to come from these column-like cells. So what happens? Now this column-like cells is again going to divide. Division is seen. So what is going to happen? From this, a group of cells will form and it is detached from their column-like cells. Now these cells are known as ectoderm. These cells will further divide and form the first layer, that is the endoderm. I'm repeating. The embryonal knob arranges in a flat disc-like manner. First division causes columnar cells and small cells. The columnar cells, they again divide to form 2 layers and the second layer of cells, they separate out. The second layer of cells, they again divide to form a ring-like structure which is close to the trophoblast. This ring-like structure is known as the endoderm. Now this is going to give rise to the primitive gut, which we can also call as elementary canal. So our elementary canal will be formed from the endoderm. Clear? Now if you see the columnar cells, there are 2 regions. This part is the head region, the embryo's head region, whereas this is called the caudal end. This is the caudal end and this is the cephalic end. From the caudal end, the cells are going to divide and they will form a group of cells here. It may form a ring or it may not form a ring or it may remain as a mass of cells. Now these mass of cells are forming the second layer which is known as the mesoderm. Okay. What happens? We are left with the cells which are present at the cephalic end. The cells of this end are going to divide to form another layer which is close to the trophoblast. So here is the another layer which forms a layer close to the trophoplast, and this layer of cells is known as the ectodermal layer. So in this way, three germ layers have been formed, and each of these three germ layers have their particular function. We have to discuss about the fate of all these three germ layers in the next class. So what did we discuss here? How did the three germ layers form? Firstly, the trophoblast. Below the trophoblast, we have the embryonal knob. The embryonal knob cells, they got compressed and they formed a disc-like structure. These disc-like structure divided, first division, the one group of cells which were tall and column-like. These cells, then the other group of cells were small, which got gradually degenerated because there was no function. Second division of the columnar cells caused a group of cells to separate out. Now these group of cells, they divided again to form a structure, a ring-like structure, which is known as the ectoderm close to the trophoderm. Now the columnar cells, the two ends, one end is called cephalic end, another is the caudal end. The cells towards the caudal end, they divided to form the mesodermal layer. And the cells towards the cephalic end, they divided to form another layer in the form of ring, which is known as the ectodermal layer. Now what happens, one thing we have to remember here is formation of amniotic disc. Now where did this, we have studied that the trophoblast gives rise to finger-like projection, and here was the columnar cells. There was a group of cells which were tall columnar cells. Then we have the ectoderm, and there was the mesoderm, and finally, endoderm, and this was the ectoderm. Now, in between this region, there is a space developed. This space is the amniotic disc. This gets filled with a fluid which is known as amnion. This amnion actually serves as a nutritive material for the developing embryo. Gradually, this amnion surrounds the entire embryo. Okay, so it is present, amniotic disc is present in between the chorionic villi and the embryonal disc. This is known as embryonal disc. Okay?